the...
So in my work on the Thai-Burma border for many years on human rights, and this is an issue that is related to trafficking, but I've been working for many years to advocate for more attention to the use of rape as a weapon of war by the Burma army against ethnic minority women. This has been going on against Shan and Karen and Mon and Chin, and all of the ethnic groups that are, of course, in conflict with the military regime and now the new government in Burma. But the rapes continue, the sexual violence continues to be widespread and, in my view, quite systematic.
You mean up till now?
Up till now, right now. The Women's League of Burma has recently issued yet another report. This isn't the first, this is one of many. I believe the title is If They Had Hope, They Would Speak, and it's documenting new cases of sexual violence against ethnic minority women in Burma. And this is related to the trafficking issue in Thailand as well, because these women tend to come over into Thailand and the Thai government is recognizing them as migrants. But unfortunately, the fact is that they've been victims of very severe human rights violations, and they really do qualify for protection under international law for seeking asylum and other forms of protection. And I think there needs to be more attention paid, obviously, within Burma in the first instance to clamp down on the Burma army and its use of sexual violence against these ethnic communities, but as well in Thailand when Burmese migrants come and they've been victims of violence, they should receive extra protection and extra assistance. I think one of the groups that is especially vulnerable, in some ways it's counterintuitive, but are the Shan who come, because they tend to not be recognized as refugees or able to live in the camps or receive assistance from some of the camps along the border, because the Thai government considers them able to blend together with Shan who live in Thailand with their ethnic kin. But unfortunately, you know, that's a group of very vulnerable people then not receiving the type of food assistance and psychosocial support and trauma counseling that they so desperately need to recover from this violence that they've experienced. And this sexual violence against women has been going on for decades, and the UN has at various times asked for an investigation. I think that is required and needed. The government in Burma, with its new openings, I think should take this very seriously. It would help a lot, of course, if a ceasefire is signed and implemented in full good faith. But even now, I believe the Burma army, it's their responsibility to be investigating these cases and cracking down on the men within their ranks who are raping women and who are really doing a lot of damage to ethnic communities in the process.